Okay, so in the last class, we had started our discussion on the continuity equation, and I have told you about the continuity equation. Just I will insert one more slide here, and I will tell you what is continuity equation. Continuity equation is basically conservation of mass principle. And suppose if we have some sort of control volume, then I can say the mass which is entering at seat at this particular section should be equal to mass which should leave the section 2. So this is very similar to steady flow equation, or rather steady flow only. So m1 dot is equal to m2. Okay, that is the continuity equation. That means whatever the mass is entering, that is leaving. So I can say if the density at seat point 1 is section 1 1 is rho 1, area is a1, and velocity of the fluid is v1. Okay, and similarly the density at section 2 is rho 2, area is a2, and the velocity is v2. Then I will say that rho 1 a1 v1 should be equal to rho 2 a2 v2. And if you will find out the units here, you will see that the units are kgs per second for both these sides. And if I consider that it's a pipeline, if it's a pipe for which area is constant, so I can say, means there can be different ways of writing it. It can be written as rho 1 v1 is equal to rho 2 v2. And let us say we can multiply a on both the sides actually, so that it gives us the mass flow rate. Now another thing is that suppose if it's a liquid, okay, if it's a liquid, and I told you for a liquid the density will not change much, so rho 1 will be equal to rho 2. So we will say that a1 v1 is equal to a2 v2. Okay, all right. So it means a into v, the product of a into v is discharge. So I will say q1 is equal to q2. So now this q is nothing but discharge, and that unit of discharge is different from that of mass flow rate. Unit of discharge is meters cube per second. Okay, so quite simple. This is the continuity equation, okay, or conservation of mass principle. So let us look at this particular numerical problem. The diameters of a pipe at sections 1 and 2 are 10 centimeter and 15 centimeter respectively. So it means this is the pipeline which is shown to us. The diameter here is 10 centimeter. The diameter here is 15 centimeter. Find the discharge through the pipe. The velocity, if the velocity of the water, so water, you can see it's a liquid now. Okay. Okay. So we don't need to consider the density actually. If it is required, we can take it also. Through the pipe at section 1 is 5 meters per second. So the velocity is given as 5 meters per second, and we have to determine the velocity at point number 2. So V2 is required at this particular location. So once again, I can always say that using the equation that if I am choosing section 1, the mass flow rate is m1 dot, and if I am choosing the section 2, mass flow rate is m2. So I can always write rho 1 a1 v1 is equal to rho 2 a2 and v2. Okay, I am crossing the v with the horizontal line, reason being v can be used for volume also. That's the only reason, otherwise there is, you can directly use v also. So as I told you, it's liquid water. Okay, so rho 1 and rho 1 will cancel out. So basically, if I know the area of the pipeline at section 1 and area of the pipeline at section 2, velocity is already known to me, V1. So So I can always calculate the value of B2. So you can see it's a very simple numerical problem. The diameter at section 1 is 10 centimeter, can be converted to meters. So area is pi by 4 d1 square. So this is the value. Velocity is this one. D2 is 15 centimeter or 0.15 meters. So we calculate the area unit using this equation pi by 4 d2 square. And discharge, once again, I have directly written it, cancelled the rho 1 and rho 2. Here they are saying that it is Q is equal to A1 V1 and Q is also equal to A2 V2. So they have used this particular concept. You can use any one of these and then solve it. It's very easy. So the final velocity comes out to be 2.22 meters per second. Any questions on this? I think it's very simple numerical problem.
Yes, I have a question.
Yes, tell me.
My question is, the discharge through the pipe, it will be the same?
Yes, it would be same, because the value, if I am calling here, is Q1, the value here, it will be Q2, and both will be same. Why they will be same? Because the density of water at section 1 is equal to density of water at section 2. See, there can be the difference in density could be there. See, that distance difference could be there. Means you can always think of that rho 1 is, I will say, it could be approximated as rho 1 is approximately equal to rho 2. There will be some difference, but that difference will not cause much change in the discharge value. Okay, that can be cancelled, because see, when the flow is taking place in a particular direction from left to right, okay, that will take place only because of there is a difference in pressures at both the points, or different in the total energy at both the points. Okay, if the energy at point number one, if I call the energy at point number one as E1 and energy at point number as E2, then E2 has to be less than E1. Okay, only then the flow will take place from left to right, actually. Okay. Otherwise, if it is higher at section 2, then the flow will take place from E2 to E1. Okay, so naturally there will be some change, but and the discharge can also be little bit no. But the thing is, the mass flow rate will be same. Mass flow rate will be same. The discharge may be a little bit may also change. Okay, discharge may change, but the mass flow rate will remain same. Okay, but because it's a liquid, so we will say that there is not much change in the discharge value also. All right. I think somebody
okay,
wants to
thank
join.
You.
Okay, somebody wants to join. Just wait.
So
yes.
Otherwise, if the density of the of water is different, so the discharge will be different also.
See, practically speaking, there won't be any large difference, actually. Okay, so practically, if you will say maybe about 0.1% or something like that, not more than that. But then theoretically speaking, you should always say that Q1 is equal to Q2. Okay. Q1 should be equal to Q2. All right. But actually, practically also, if you see, whatever is the fluid entering at a particular location, same is leaving at the other location. Okay. Now, let us see this question. A 30 centimeter diameter pipe. So, it's here. Okay. Conveying water branches into two pipes of diameters 20 centimeter. This is the 20 centimeter pipe. This is 15 centimeter pipe. Once again, somebody wants to join. Okay, so diameters are 20 centimeter and 15 centimeter. So we have already denoted these two. If the average velocity in 30 centimeter diameter pipe is 2.5 meter per second, so the velocity here is 2.5, find the discharge in this pipe okay, also determine velocity in 15 centimeter pipe. So we have to calculate this particular velocity. This is unknown. If the average velocity in 20 centimeter diameter pipe is 2 meter, so the velocity here is 2 meter. Okay, so this is quite easy. So you can easily say that if this value, the discharge which is entering here is Q1, then the discharge which is leaving here is Q2, the discharge which is leaving here is Q3. So you can directly write the equation Q1 is equal to Q2 plus Q3. Okay, so we are theoretically saying that this is the condition which is prevailing here in this particular case. So I can write A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2 plus A3 V3, and area is, as you know, is given by pi by 4 d square. So I can always write pi by 4. From here I can write pi by 4 d1 square v1 is equal to pi by 4 d2 square v2 plus pi by 4 d3 square v3. So pi by 4 and pi by 4 will cancel out, and the value of diameter d1 is available to us. This is available to us. Velocity v1 is available to us. Then d2 is available to us. V2 is available to us. D3 is available to us. So only unknown is v3. Okay, that is how we can calculate the velocity v3. And if we want to calculate q1, so the value of q1 is quite easy to calculate. A1 v1, which is equal to, as I told you, A1 v1 will be calculated very easily from here. Okay, so this can be easily calculated. So I think the solution is given here. You can see it here. It's not needed here actually. First of all, they are calculating all the areas and then calculating the velocities or discharge they are calculating. So it's a very big way of doing this numerical problem. I have explained you in a simple manner, which is there. Okay, and this problem I have already sent you. You can see from there, or you can follow my method. So this method will be easier for you. Okay, once more there is a call. So I think is it clear to you, numerical problem? Is it clear? Okay, so I will proceed further. Now let us go to Bernoulli's equation. Now this is about you can see here we are talking about the Bernoulli's equation from Euler's equation. So this is not required actually. We are interested in only Bernoulli's equation. Okay, and it is, if the flow is incompressible and the density is constant, then this equation is known as Bernoulli's equation. Okay, this is Bernoulli's equation. Now what is Bernoulli's equation? I will explain you, don't worry about that. It is given by P by rho plus GZ plus V square by 2 is equal to constant. So basically it is comprising of three terms. Okay, it is P by rho. P by rho is related to pressure. So if you see the equation which is given below here, okay, we have divided the whole equation by G here. Okay, so the first term becomes P by rho G, the second term is Z, the third term is V square by 2G. And there is another way of writing it also. You can multiply the whole equation by rho G also. Okay, if I multiply the whole equation by rho G, so it will become P in plus rho G Z plus rho V square by 2 is equal to constant. So these are the three ways of writing the Bernoulli's equation. Okay, so what I will do, I will just try to tell you that what is this first equation which is written here. It is P by rho. Okay, you just focus here. It is P by rho. Now let us try to understand. I can tell you, so see, basically Bernoulli's equation is a type of energy equation only. So it is talking about the energy only. So P by rho, what is P? P is pressure, and it has the units newtons per meter square. ओके डिवाइडेड बाय रो, रो हैज द यूनिट्स केजीज पर मीटर क्यूब. सो जस्ट ट्राई टू फोकस इट हेयर, व्हाट डू यू गेट, मीटर स्क्वायर एंड दिस कैंसल्स आउट. ओके सो इट बिकम्स न्यूटन केजी एंड मीटर. सो कैन यू सी, कैन डू यू नो व्हाट इज न्यूटन मीटर? न्यूटन मीटर स्टैंड फॉर जूल्स पर केजी. नाउ जूल इज द यूनिट ऑफ एनर्जी, सो इट मीन्स द फर्स्ट टर्म हेयर विच इज पी बाय रो इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग एनर्जी पर यूनिट मास. ओके एनर्जी पर यूनिट मास. नाउ यू थिंक अबाउट जी जेड. If you remember what is potential energy, potential energy is given by mgz. Now when I say mgz, it means its unit will come out to be joules. Okay, but here the term is gz, so it will come out to be joules per kg. So it is potential energy per unit mass. Okay, the first term which was written here as p by rho is actually pressure energy per unit mass. Okay, so all these are energy terms. If you see v square by 2, what is v square by 2? It is kinetic energy, but mass is not multiplied here. So the third term which is given here is v square by 2, so it is kinetic energy per unit mass. So it is basically, we have added three types of the energies here: p by rho, which is the pressure energy per unit mass, gz is the potential energy per unit mass, and v square by 2 is the kinetic energy per unit mass. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Now the second way of writing this equation is this one. Okay, it is written here p by rho g plus z plus v square by 2g is equal to constant. Now let us try to understand what it is actually p by rho g. See, you know that small w, which is the specific weight. Okay, it is the specific weight. It is actually given as rho into g. Okay, and it has the units newton per meter cube. Okay, we defined the unit of the specific weight in the first class on fluid mechanics. So what is p by rho g? So let us try to see it here. P by rho g, rho g. Okay, so do you remember the equation of pressure? Pressure we defined as rho g h. Okay, so it means we can write p as rho g h, and in denominator we have rho g, so rho g and rho g will cancel out and we are left with only h, and h is the unit of length or height, so its unit should be meters. So p by rho g is meters. So the first term here, p by rho g, is representing pressure head. Okay, it is representing pressure head. The second term is z. Now this is the elevation head. Okay, this is elevation head. Then comes v square by 2g, and if even if you will calculate its unit, you will find that it comes out to be in meter. So it is actually known as kinetic head. So it is head equivalent to kinetic energy. It is kinetic head. So it says that if a fluid is flowing in a pipeline, okay, or in a some other place, this is the fluid which is flowing, then if I am taking two sections, this is the section one and this is the section two, then at both these sections the energy will be constant. That means the total energy at section 1 will be equal to a total energy at section 2. Okay, so I will take the next slide. Yeah, I can write it here. So I am saying that if this is the pipeline, okay, this is the section 1 and this is the section 2, so I will say the energy here is even, which is given by P by rho, P1 by rho plus, or rho 1 you can say, plus V1 square by 2 plus G Z1. So that is the energy at section 1. Okay. So you can see this equation from here. It is the first equation. You can see P by rho plus Gz plus V square by 2. Okay. And similarly, I can write the energy at section 2. Section 2, it would be P 2 by rho 2 plus V square V 2 square by 2 plus G Z 2. So once again, I will say that this is the pressure energy. Okay, per unit mass. This is kinetic energy per unit mass, and this is the potential energy per unit mass. So I can say that as per Bernoulli's equation, E1 should be equal to E2 when I am considering there are no losses. Okay, so this is how we can write the Bernoulli's equation. Or I can always say that energy E remains constant when a fluid flow is taking place. Means the fluid is entering here, the fluid is leaving here. I can take any section. I can take section A here. So it means EA will also be equal to E1 equal to E2 and so on. You can choose any section. So this is the Bernoulli's equation. Now, what are the assumptions? Assumptions are the fluid is ideal. That means its viscosity is zero. So it actually tells us that there won't be any losses actually. The flow is steady. You know about the steady flow. Okay. The flow is incompressible. That is also known to you. And the flow is irrotational. So these are some of the assumptions which we make while deriving this particular equation. But the derivation of this equation is not in your course. You only need to remember the sum of pressure energy plus kinetic energy plus potential energy is equal to constant. Now let us write it in the second form. The second form, as you have seen it, is P by rho g plus V1 square rho 1, you can say by 2g plus z1, okay, is equal to p2 by rho 2 into g plus v2 square by 2 plus z2. So this is pressure head, means p by rho g stands for pressure head. This stands for kinetic head. And this stands for elevation head or potential head. Elevation or potential head. Okay. So it means the total head. Total head is constant. It says that total head is constant. So what are the various heads? The first one is the head due to pressure energy. The second one is the head due to kinetic energy. And the third one is the head due to potential energy. That will remain constant. Or I can say HP1 plus H kinetic energy at section 1 plus H potential energy at section 1 will be equal to pressure head at section 2 plus pressure head due to kinetic energy at section 2 plus pressure head due to potential energy at section 2. This is constant. So I hope this part is clear to you. Is it? Any questions on this? So this is very, very similar to the steady flow energy equation, okay, and I can prove it also. For example, this I will explain to you later on. We have written the steady flow energy equation as QCV minus WCV is equal to DH plus डी के ई प्लस डी पी ई. ओके, दिस वॉज द स्टैटिक फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन. एंड नाउ वी आर अप्लाइंग इट टू ए फ्लूइड विच इज फ्लोइंग इन ए पाइपलाइन. दिस इज द फ्लूइड विच इज फ्लोइंग इन ए पाइपलाइन. हेयर एंड हेयर वी आर कंसिडरिंग टू सेक्शंस, वन एंड टू. सो इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ए पाइपलाइन and we can consider that there is no heat exchange with the surroundings and there is no work, so these two terms can be neglected. Okay, so what we are left with, dh, dke, dpe. So dh, h is here enthalpy. Okay, it is enthalpy here. So h 1 plus kinetic energy term is v1 square by 2 plus potential energy term is G Z2 G Z1. Okay, that should be equal to H2 plus V2 square by 2 plus G Z2. Okay, now this we can write as enthalpy is U plus P1 V1. Okay, plus V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 is equal to H2. I can write as U2 plus P2 V2 plus V2 square by 2 plus GZ2. Okay, now what I can say is, I can say here is that if I think about the kinetic energy term here and here, U1 and U2, they will be same. They will be same because I am saying that there is no exchange of heat transfer. So whatever is the temperature here, same will be the temperature here. Okay. So I can say that this change in internal energy, you know that change in internal energy is given by Cv T2 minus T1. So this value is actually zero. Okay, this value is zero actually. So naturally I can cancel it here and here. So I am left with P1 V1. So P V1 V is actually 1 by rho. Okay, so here I can write P1 by rho 1 plus V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 is equal to P2 by rho 2 plus V2 square by 2 plus GZ2. Okay. That is how we can get. And you can see this is the same equation which we have written. Okay. So I hope from this particular equation which I have just derived here, you can get this particular equation also. Okay, it is P1 plus by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. Yes, there is one more term which has been added here, which is HL. Now, what is this HL representing here actually? Now, you read the heading. It is Bernoulli's equation for a real fluid. So, in a real fluid, there would be some loss of energy. So if I am saying that the energy here is E1 and energy here is E2 and it's a real fluid, so some energy will be lost while it is flowing from section 1 to section 2 actually. Okay, so it means E2 has to be less than E1, so the difference of two will be actually equal to head loss or loss of energy. So you can see here, this term, this whole term is actually representing E1 energy at section 1. This whole term is representing the energy at section 2. And I told you this loss of energy, this head loss, because if you see P1 by rho g, it is the pressure head. Okay. This is in meters of a particular fluid column actually. So head loss or loss of energy is given by E1 minus E2. Okay, so that is how we can calculate the loss of head in a real fluid. So is it clear to you? Just tell me.
Show us.
Okay. So you can read it here. The Bernoulli's equation was derived on the assumption that the fluid is inviscid, that means non-viscous, and therefore frictionless. But all real fluids are viscous and hence offer resistance to flow. Thus, there are always some losses in fluid flows, and hence in the applications of the Bernoulli's equation, these losses have to be taken into consideration. Thus, the Bernoulli's equation for real fluids between section 1 or points 1 and 2 is given as. So this is the equation which has been written. Whatever I have derived here up till here in this particular point, that is Bernoulli's equation for a ideal fluid. So this is valid for a ideal fluid. Okay. And here this is for the real fluid, the top one equation. Okay. This equation. This is valid for a real fluid. Okay. So once again, what I will do, I will take you to the last page here. Once again, I will write the Bernoulli's equation if it is a ideal fluid. Okay. I can write it as P1 by rho 1 plus V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 is equal to P2 by rho 2 plus V2 square by 2 plus GZ2. I think somebody wants to join. Just wait. And or I can say that P, yeah, color is changed. I can say P1 by rho 1 G plus V1 square by 2 G means I am dividing the all terms by G. So it will be Z1 is equal to P2 by rho 2 G plus V2 square by 2 G plus Z2. Okay. This is in terms of heads and the units are meters. For all terms, whereas if you will find out here, it is energy per unit mass and the units are joules per kg. So these are two ways. Third way, I have also told you, you can write it as P1 plus rho 1 V1 square by 2 plus M. Rho G Z1 is equal to, rather it would be rho 1, okay? P2 plus rho 2 V2 square by 2 plus it will be rho G Z2, okay? This is the third way. And if you will see this particular equation, this is in the units of pressure. Okay, this is in the units of pressure, newtons per meter square. So this is the pressure which is existing here, or the static pressure of the fluid. Okay, this you can call it as the static pressure. This you can call as the kinetic pressure. Okay, this is the pressure due to elevation. Okay, so there are three ways you can write this Bernoulli's equation, and only change which you will see in case of real fluids. Okay, if I call all these terms which are written here on the left hand side, I call all these as by the name E1. Okay, I am calling all these as even. Even has different meanings depending upon the means the terms which are there in the equation actually. Okay, and on the term which the right hand side terms are represented as E2. Okay, all these terms are E2. So for a real fluid, E1 is equal to E2 plus you can always say that there is delta E loss. Okay, delta is loss. Means there is some loss of energy when the fluid is flowing. Okay, so you can write it in different ways. Okay, so for example, if you see this first equation, this equation. So for this, you can always write for this equation. You can say it is E1 is equal to E2 plus loss of energy, because here the units of energy per unit mass. The second one is in the terms of head. So you can always say that it is the if I am calling H as the total head on the left hand side, H1 is equal to H2 plus head loss. Okay, HL. This is corresponding to second case. And if you want to write it for the third case, you can write it as you can say but the P1 is already being used here. So I will say this is the total pressure head. Total pressure. I will put a cut mark here. P1 is equal to P2 plus there is some loss of pressure. Okay, so that is how we can just to make you understand. Otherwise, the green color in which I have written this equation in three different ways, that is not required actually. You can only remember this particular thing. Okay, that is sufficient actually. So I have explained you about this particular equation. So now I will go to some one or two numerical problem. So the most important numerical problem, or first of all, let us go to this one. State Bernoulli's theorem for steady flow of an incompressible fluid. Okay, the derivation is not required actually. This part is not required, but just assumptions made for such a derivation. Assumptions we should know. Okay. So what is the statement of the Bernoulli's theorem? It states that in a steady ideal flow of an incompressible fluid. So when I say ideal flow means it's an ideal fluid actually. So there is no friction at all, okay, between the layers. So it's a case of Bernoulli's equation when the energy at section 1 will be equal to energy at section 2. So this is the pressure energy P by rho g. That is, if you see here, it is the head of pressure actually. It is the units are meters actually, because it is P by rho g. Similarly, it is kinetic energy. Rather than kinetic energy, it is kinetic head. So HKE, okay, because it is also in meters. And datum energy or datum head or elevation head, so it is Z. So it is H corresponding to potential energy. So mathematically, Bernoulli's theorem is written as P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus Z is equal to constant. Though I have written it as E1 is equal to E2, I could have written it as total energy E remains constant, and this E is nothing but this all these three terms actually. Okay, so let us go to this particular problem. I think this is quite easy, not difficult at all, and it is based on the discharge actually, so I won't be doing it. It is problem number 6.2. So what you can do is you can just try it. I will go to a difficult numerical problem here. Yeah, not difficult, rather more conceptual. Okay, it's a more conceptual problem. It says the water is flowing through a pipe having diameter 20 centimeter and 10 centimeter at section 1 and 2 respectively. So this is section 1. Okay, this is section 2, and the diameter here is 20 centimeters and the diameter here is 10 centimeters. The rate of flow through pipe is 35 liters per second. So it means it is saying that Q1 is equal to Q2 equal to 35 liters per second. Now I will tell you that you should always remember that 1 meter cube is always equal to 1000 liters. Okay, so it means 1 liter is equal to 10 raised to power minus 3 meter cubes. So if it is if I have to write in SI system of units, Q1 will be equal to Q2 equal to 35 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meters cubes per second. So that is the value of Q1 and Q2. The section 1 is 6 meters above the datum. So this is the datum line. So it is 6 meters. So that is the value of Z1. Okay. Similarly, the Section 2 is 4 meters above the datum, so this is the value of Z2. Okay, 4 meter. If the pressure at section 1 is 39.24 Newton per centimeter square, so this is the value of the pressure here, 39.24 Newton per centimeter square. So I won't like to take this value in Newton per centimeter square, rather it should be in Pascals. So Pascals mean Newton per meter square. So you can see here, this is P1, it is 39.24, and when we convert this centimeter square into meter square, you will have to multiply it by 10 raised to power 4. So this is 39.24 into 10 raised to power 4 newtons per meter square, or you can call it as Pascals also. And Z1 we have already noted. D2 is known. Area you need to calculate, it's okay. Z2 is 4. So it says, now find the intensity of pressure at section 2. So we have to calculate what is the pressure at point 2. That is what is required. Now, very, very simple question. Once again, it is saying nothing about the head loss. Okay. So nothing is mentioned about the head loss or the energy loss. Okay. It is not mentioned here. So we don't have to consider it. So what we can consider is energy at section 1. E1 is equal to E2. Okay, so that is what we require to look at. And now just focus here. Suppose if I have to calculate the energy at point number 1. So energy at point number 1 will be given by P1 by W. Okay, I have not written the energy equation in this fashion, but it is clear that we can write it as in this manner also, V1 square by 2G plus Z1. Okay, because W1 is nothing but it is rho 1G. Okay, W is the specific weight. Now you tell me, what are the items which are known to me in this particular case? So let us try to understand. P1. Is P1 known to me? Yes, P1 is here. You can see it here. I will change the color to red. So P1 is known to me. Okay. So this is known to me. W1. Density of water. Okay. It's water. So the density of water is always equal to 1000 kgs per meter cube. Nobody is going to tell you this value. Actually, you should always remember it. So rho 1 is known to me. G is known to me. What about V1? V1. Do you know V1? No, V1 is not known to me. G, yes, G is known to you. Z1 is known to you. So when I have to calculate the value of E1, I need to calculate the value of V1. Okay. Similarly, if you see section 2, there may be certain things which you may not be knowing. But the first and the foremost thing that we need to calculate is the velocity at section 1. If I am able to calculate the velocity at section 1, then I know the value of E1 or the energy. And this energy E1, you know, is also equal to energy E2 from this particular equation. This is Bernoulli's equation. So how to calculate velocity V1? Can anybody tell me? Tell me how to calculate the velocity at section 1. See, I know that the Q1 will be given by area at section 1 multiplied by the velocity at section 1. And the value of Q1 is already known to me. Q1 is already known to me. Okay. Area at section 1, it's a pipe. So area has been calculated here. Pi by 4 into D square. So area is known to me. So only unknown in this equation is V1. So V1 calculated. V1 can be calculated from this particular equation. And what is Q1? Q1 is the discharge at section 1. And it is equal to the discharge at section 2. Okay. So is it clear? So that means, though I am not just seeing the numerical problem, but I am explaining you how we can do it. So I think, yes, you can see it here. So they have used the same equation. And they have calculated the velocity at both section 1 and section 2 also. Because Q1 is equal to Q2. Only thing is that the area is different. So this is the velocity at section 1 and this is the velocity at section 2. And then you just have to apply the Bernoulli's equation at section 1 and 2. It is P1 by rho g, V1 square by 2g, Yes, any questions? Okay. Z1 and P2 by rho g, V2 square by 2g and Z2. So you have to calculate this particular value. This is unknown. Rather, this particular value, pressure. This is unknown to me. Okay, P2 is unknown to me. V2 we have just calculated. Just a minute. V2 we have calculated. Then rho is already known to me. See, in case of liquids, I told you that rho 1 is equal to rho 2 and its water, so it will remain as 1000 kgs per meter cube. Okay, so this value is already known to me. So V2 is also known to me. Z2 is also known to me. P1 by rho g, V1 square by 2g, Z1, all these are known to me. Only unknown is this P2. So P2 can be calculated. So you can see it here. You just have to use the consistent set of the units and then you would be able to calculate the P2 as Newton per meter square, 41.051 into 9810. I'm not just giving you the values. Values you can put yourself. I am just explaining you the procedure right now. Okay, this is how you can use this Bernoulli's equation. And it is nothing but you can say, it's only the steady flow energy equation in which the value of Q and W is not there. Okay, so we have neglected heat transfer and work transfer. Now, one very important thing, what you can do is, there is